What's up, y'all? I know you missed us. We're back. All right, let's get straight to it as usual. Behind me, I have our client's 2020 Widebody Hellcat. So let's just take a second to view it. Beautiful piece of work. Let's get into it. All right, so this car, our customer Ken has given us free reign to do a lot of the modifications that we did to it. And I'm real happy with how it came out. So we'll start off with the exterior and then work our way to the interior. So right here, he brought a Extreme Dimensions front bumper, which basically the client wanted it because it had the dual scoops in the front, which gave him more cooling for his brakes. And actually aesthetically, it looks better. But the problem was the bumper fit like shit from the get-go. As you can see in pictures that Josh will loop in, the gaps basically to the fenders, to the bumper, all that shit was just horrible. So what we had to do is we actually sectioned it, keeping the original body lines all the way down here, cut it, and then sectioned it all the way across. So the original polyurethane bumpers up here, all fiberglass down there. My guys did a phenomenal job on the bodywork, and then the paint, you know, we kill it as always. Then we actually went with a little two-tone to kind of accent the rear, which you'll see in a minute. But we hit it with a gloss black in the center section, and then accented that with a nice little silver ring all the way around to accent the front little lip that we made. So basically, when he pulls up in driveways, that aluminum lip will save his front end. Now we're moving sideways. All right. As you can see, this thing's dropped on the Ibrock Sport Kit suspension. He's sitting on his custom set of three-piece wheels that he brought to us to install. Fitment on this thing is amazing. Just how we like it, no gaps. Hugging the thorn. We actually color matched the full lower kit on this, front lips, side skirts, rear diffuser to match the full body exterior color. Two-tone the Hellcat logos to match the center of the wheels. That just gets better, just gets better. Back here, I still have not seen anybody else doing what we're doing on these. X-Loom supplies these light up Hellcat logos, and Vlad is able to flush mount these into the rear of the taillights. The amount of work that goes into these, I can't even explain how much, but it looks phenomenal when it lights up. This one we have basically on ignition, so as soon as he turns the car on, it lights up red, and it's just a small little detail that nobody's got besides us, so hit us up for that. Put my flag down, shit, dang, really. Just in case you need detailing needs, I got you. Just hit me up at the shop. I charge $35. Per wipe on vehicles. Back to the car. All right, under the hood, we got the strut tower braces under the hood, and in the rear, we upgraded the intake to a JLT cold air intake, JBA smog legal headers, and QTP electric exhaust cutouts. Have this thing sounding good, handling good, and god damn it, looking good. In the interior, customer brought us the carbon fiber steering wheel that we installed, then brought us this Hurst shifter. Now the problem with these shifters normally is you have nowhere to put the shift indicator. The company actually tells you to pretty much zip tie it and throw it underneath. That's not how we do it at the shop. Once again, we fabricated a nice little bezel to mount the shifter. So basically you have the Hurst shifter with the factory indicator logos there. So it works just how it should. So once again, this car has got so many little small details that like would normally go overlooked. So that's why we did a little video to explain it. Enjoy. Got a lot of M's on my mind and my friends. Yeah, I keep my friends on my mind. I'm in love with two girls at one time and they tens. That's why I got 10 on my mind. I got M's, got a lot of M's on my mind and my friends. Yeah, I keep my friends on my mind. Should repent. I need me some Jesus in my life. Amen.